So what changed there? I guess midway through the third, you're down left.
Yeah, I think, you know, our defense started to pick up. You know, when you look at Luka in that first half, couldn't ask for a better quarter offensively for, you know, someone. And then I think defensively we started to, you know, get stops. And then, again, with the double teams, we know we've seen it all season where to be, and I thought we started to execute that better there in the third. And I think, you know, the middle of the third on, we started to play defense like we did on the road trip.
Why do you think it took so long to get for other guys to kind of get involved?
Luka was going. I mean, he first half was pretty productive. I think he had only 10 shots, 27 points. So when you look at what he was doing offensively, you know, just being able to keep us in the game. And then when, you know, he's been very unselfish with the double teams. And you know, guys, Reggie makes some big shots for us tonight. Josh, you know, was good too in the double team. And so I think it's just, you know, the rhythm of those shots we just have to be consistent with because we're going to see that all year. And once we started to be, you know, to knock those down, our defense picked up. And then I think just an early transition, being able to attack before the double team came.
Do you, when you were looking out on the court first half, do you feel like you guys were connected?
Yeah, I think we were connected. I think, you know, sometimes when someone comes back, you tend to wait. And, you know, Spencer, after the last two games, was playing at a high level. I thought he was letting Luka dictate everything instead of just playing the game that he was playing the last two. Luka's going to join the party. He's too talented. Not to the ball's going to find him. And I thought, you know, at halftime we talked about Reggie looking to shoot the ball and then Spencer looking to be aggressive, act as if Luka is not out there. And that's, you know, and I thought he started to do that there in the start of the third. Even though he missed a couple layups, it was just him being aggressive and the ball touching the paint, which helps everybody.
Do you feel like it was a good matchup for JaVale in this situation?
Yeah, we got in foul trouble. And I thought JaVale, being a pro, he came in and he gave us a spark there in that first half. And so, you know, we started him in the second. He got us off in the third. And so then passing the baton to DP and Doe playing the five there in the third and fourth. I thought JaVale was a big part of our success there to keep us in the game in that first half.
You mentioned that Spencer let Luka dictate in that, you know, in the first half. He only took three shots. How do you get involved, or how do you let that play out with letting Spencer be himself or let Luka dictate everything?
You got to hold them accountable. I think as much as a coach, you know, you can yell and scream, but the opportunity of being accountable as a teammate, when you wear that jersey, you have to tell your teammate he's not doing his job. You can't be afraid to tell someone that they're not doing their job. And that person who's hearing that has to accept that and respond. And I thought at halftime we talked about that, and I thought the guys did a really good job of responding.
In the same way, there was a moment in tonight's game when Tim Hardaway Jr. went to the bench, ripped his jersey, was visibly frustrated with this play. What's your message to him, or what was the team's message to him?
Yeah, I think Timmy is trying to do everything to help the team, and that's the beauty of Tim right now. We would like him to make all the shots, but right now they're just in and out. It's the life of a shooter. And I think everybody's still supportive. You look at the defensive end, we're asking him to guard bigger guys and rebound for us, and he's doing that. He cares about the team. Sometimes frustration sets in, but you, as a coach or a teammate, you like to see that because he cares. Thanks.
Thank you. Question for a person, thank you.
One question for each point?
Sure.
Okay. No. In Phoenix game, yes.
Oh. Well played.
We assume the ankle is feeling okay?
Well, it's good. Still not, obviously not 100%, but it's good. Did some good work.
Do you have concern when you're out there and you have to score 18 of the first 20 points and you guys are barely kind of staying afloat?
I mean, I really think we had, in the first half especially, pretty good looks. You know, it just didn't go in. Sometimes they doubled, sometimes they didn't. But I think we had really great looks.
What did you see from Spencer in the two games that you were out, and how can you get more out of that from him?
I mean, he's an amazing player, man. Just needs to stay aggressive, you know, play his game, get going, and he's an amazing player.
When you start hot from three, and I think you have four or five in the first quarter, how does that affect your shot selection? Were you shooting a few more early on and then had to get back to driving to the rim?
Somebody told me I was 12 for 13 from two, so probably I should have taken more twos than threes, but I think that's efficient three finally for me. That's it.
What did their assistant coach, Jerome Allen, say to get you to get under your skin, to get you guys going back and forth? And
I mean, since the first quarter, he was chirping, but you know I chirped back. I don't have a problem.
What was he chirping about?
I don't know. That was from the first quarter, he was just chirping. I don't want to say the words, but I have no problem with that. It's basketball. Gets me going for sure. I don't have no problem with that.
Do you enjoy it?
Yeah. I do sometimes, sometimes no.
I noticed several times you hit a shot and it seemed like you were kind of playing along with the soldiers on the side, like, you know, nodding toward them. And did you notice them surrounding the court?
I mean, yeah, of course.
Big part of the game?
Yeah, of course I noticed. Now we're going to go meet them. But I was just, you know, playing the game, trying to win the game. But it's obviously a very special night because we didn't have it with 2 years now. So now we're back to it.
How do you kind of get a feel for, like, you got it going, you know you can score if they don't W, but you're trying to keep teammates in a rhythm? How do you kind of feel that out?
I mean, sometimes you just got to accept the coverage. You know, obviously when they're doubling, if I would have waited, sometimes it would still come double. But sometimes just before they go, just attack and attack the paint every time. Good.
Yep.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.